Assalamu alaikum and welcome to Jam Sonic Solutions. This is the second of the Baroque Volume 3 replicas. Okay, so I've made the previous one in a terracotta color, and this cream one is a very, very classic suit which I'm going to be hopefully sewing in a very classic and simple style. With a slight bit of add-ons from myself, so it's like a jacket suit. We're going to make the undergarment as a chemise, a dress and a trouser, and then hopefully this make this into a jacket. Now I have done a couple of I'm going to be doing a couple of modifications of myself. This lace was the initial lace that was attached on this lace was the initial one that was attached on the border here, and I've taken this off because one of the reasons, main reasons being that the lace is only supplied for the front area, which I'm not too keen on having the back as a plain, totally plain. Now I would love to have had this in maybe even a contrasting color at the back, or a fully embroidered panel at the back, which is probably something that Baroque does as the originals, as a full embroidered panel at the back. Unfortunately, these are replicas and these are for the fraction of the price of the originals, so they don't come as the fabric is different, and also the embroidery will slightly vary. Okay, but it doesn't mean, for the fraction of the price of the original, we can get a very nice result. For the amount of wears that we often get from these clothes, these are ideal, especially for those of my lovely members who sew for themselves. So if you're someone who loves to double in sewing yourself, then these are ideal, because even if you made a slight bit of a mess of it, you could still get a decent enough result to wear. And they are very pretty suits, and they are a fraction of the price, and also if you're sewing yourself, you'll be saving a massive sewing bill. And the beauty is that you can actually buy the suit and stitch it and wear it the next day. So anyway, so many advantages to sewing yourself. This is one of the aims of the videos, to try and encourage viewers to sew for themselves. Please do not message me if I will sew for you, because I am so chock-a-block with time. The only thing I do is to share the videos with you and to try and motivate and encourage you to do it for yourself. Two main reasons for doing the videos. One is to show you what the result would look like, and so that gives you an idea whether to go ahead and purchase something like this. If it's something that doesn't appeal to you, then fair enough, you've got an idea, you've seen how the suit was made, you've seen what you got at the initial stage, and if it doesn't appeal to you, then you can walk away and not waste your money in buying the suit. So that's the first reason why these videos are created. And secondly, is to give you ideas on how you can transform these suits into something, hopefully something better. Gives you an idea on how to stitch the suit yourself and how to get the best wear out of it. So anyway, full of ideas, and I hope you continue watching and benefiting from the videos. So what we're going to do is, initially what we've done is pull the whole suit apart, taken off all the bits. Now generally when these edges are turned, they're not turned for the finishing touch. So it's an unsalvaged raw edge, which you do have to unpick and press. Okay, so the first thing to do is to unpick it nicely, take away all the irrelevant threads and so on, press it and have it laid out to your desire. Now the other thing to the point of these videos is to give you an idea for your size and your build, and whether it's an idea to get something like this or how you're going to stitch this. Now the length of this suit is 38 inches. The maximum that we're going to get out of this is 39 inches. So if you're looking for something for 44 inch length, then you know this suit is not for you. Also the styling, do you want it as a suit, do you want it as a jacket? I mean, this suit is very nice if you wear a bias and so on, then I would encourage someone to buy something like this, because what you can do is make the plain suit and make the jacket, and you can wear the jacket with an abaya. So these are just like all informational ideas for you. Okay. Also, the other things to bear in mind is with these suits, often the fabrics are slightly less, and you do have to add small pieces here and there. Now, with this, the sleeve is coming out like 3/4 length. If you wear full sleeves, then you will have a problem, or you'd have to add extensions. Also, it's not wide enough on the armhole, so you will again have to add pieces. That's just a little bit of an information. Apart from that, it's a very pretty embroidery suit, and we're gonna have a slight bit of add-ons of our own. I'm gonna be using this lace to finish it off at the bottom, and I'm also gonna be combining this with pearl lace to finish it off. I want to get a prettiest result as possible, and the pieces that we've taken off from the bottom of the hemline, I'm gonna be combining this to finish the trouser off. So keep on watching for the final result, and hopefully, who is this video gonna appeal to? Well, if you've got something like this and if you want to purchase it, then this video is for you to watch. The continuing videos are for you to watch. If it's something that doesn't appeal to you, then this is your cue for exiting the video and hopefully joining for something which is far more of an appeal to you. Inshallah, take care, and I will join those of you who are going to be sewing something like this. We will be cutting and partly showing the stitching of this suit. So take care, have a wonderful day, and bye for now. Okay, so welcome back. Now, when you come to sewing something like this, once you've pressed it out, you've got to lay it on top of each other and make sure that the embroidery is symmetric as possible, and it's matching. Now, unfortunately, sometimes when we get these suits, because they're individually embroidered, they're not always symmetrical, and if the embroidery is not symmetrical, you will end up having problems. Also, when you're trying to match these out, you may have problems on some pieces being wider than the other. So that's a secondary problem, that these are all minor flaws that come with these fabrics, and you have to try and get these minor flaws out to the best as possible. Okay, now I mentioned that the length of this suit is going to come out as 39 as the maximum. Okay, so the neckline is predetermined. It's just going to be a round neckline, fairly wide, and I'm just going to line this. So the outer line of the neckline, leaving about half an inch of sewing space, I just mark it out. And then also at the top, although the length could have come out longer, what they've done is when they've embroidered this, they've left a massive gap, so we can't use that fabric on top, because then the neckline would come out too low. Okay, so we're marking it out for the shoulders, and then the armhole. And now I'm just one of those people who has the general key eye for what the cutting is going to be, especially when I've sewn like a multitude of clothes for someone. And then even without measurements, I can generally grasp where it is, how far I'm cutting, and the kind of cutting that I will be doing. Now, it's a slight A line it's going to be, and that's the waistline. Waistline is generally about 16 inches, 15 to 16 inches from the top of the shoulder. The armhole, the general length of the armhole is approximately 7 inches with about 3 inches across. So the method that I tend to suggest to people is to measure 3.5 inches across, and then straight up 7 inches down, and then create a curve, and waistline, hip line. And this is going to be a jacket which is going to be hopefully closed from the sides because it's going to be open from the front. And now I'm going to create a slight bit of a fall towards the back. I'm going to create it more of like a not a complete trailed, but slightly longer rounded off at the back, because we're going to be finishing it off with a heavy sort of like a border, and I don't want to create a cut in the border. Okay, so having marked this out, I'm just going to cut around the edges of where I've marked it out. Now on top of the shoulder, I've left, on top of the embroidery, I've left a space of about half an inch, and that's just to give me enough seaming space, and then I will get to the embroidery. Now I can't actually emphasize how important, you know, this grid mark can prove to be for people who are new at sewing. It will help you so much, and I would highly encourage all viewers who've not attempted to make one. It's simple to make. There is a video available online, and it teaches you how to mark it out and how to create. Now I have got a purpose grid mat as well, and but you know what, I use the fabric one just to highlight the qualities of using your own, because not everybody has the capability to go and buy the ready-made ones. So you know what, it's something which is easily done. Okay, so that's the front two panels. I'm just going to take the front panels, lay them to a side, lay out the fabric for the back. Now with the back, obviously we've had the front, we've got the problem with the embroidery at the bottom, the embroidery missing at the top, so the length would have come out shorter on this, but we can compensate. We can compensate. Naya! Turn that off. Take it away from here. It's annoying me. Right, so as I don't think you'll be able to. Right, okay. So here what we've got is, because of the difference of sizing of the embroidery, having the embroidery on the front and so on, what we've got is we can actually make the back slightly bit longer without having too many problems. From the top, I'm just going to use the guideline. So here at the bottom, I'm just going to show you before I take the camera to the other side. We're going to just measure it along to the same size as the finishing, and then we're just going to curve it so that it gives us, what we've got is approximately 4 inches longer at the back. Okay, the width I've kept them same. Now going up, what we're going to do is use the template of the front dress to cut out our back, and on the waistline and on the hip line and going down to the bottom, we're just going to use the same outline. Okay, so I know you won't be able to tell fully with the markings, but that's irrelevant. Really no need for to have the ability, because what the camera, what you'll see better is if you're using something like, as I pointed out, if you're using something like a grid mat, you can see that the you know, the center point of this is straight. The kind of curves that this is creating, a good cut will always help you to get such a good result. Honestly, I can't even emphasize how important that is. There we are. So we'll use these pieces for helping us with the sleeves. Now what we're going to have is, this is going to be combined and stitched along this. It's going to be shorter at the front as it goes to the back. It sort of like curves quite a bit. We've got probably about 8 inches shorter at the front than we have at the back, and then when we've got the lace all applied on, and you know, this is going to finish off a nice border. You know, it's going to give it a really nice finishing to the border. And that's going to be hopefully a brilliant result to this beautiful suit. So I'll just cut along the sleeves, and then what we'll do is cut the trouser and the undersuit for this. Now the sleeves, they are coming out slightly short, so what we'll do with these sleeves is that we'll, and also it's coming out tight from here. Two things we'll need: one, a piece adding at the front to make the sleeves longer, and also we'll need pieces adding to the under armhole just to make this wider. So we take our leftover pieces, slightly overlap them, just need two pieces. These were the leftover pieces that have come out from the side of the camise. These are already overlocked as well, so the good thing is that you can stick one to the other without having to and you can place these a lot lower because so these pieces will stick on, and we'll stick them on. We'll shape the armhole again once we've done the initial sewing, and then decide on what we're going to add to the front of these sleeves. I like the sleeves on these like full. I'm not really too keen on them having them like three quarter and stuff. So what I'll do is I'll probably apply this lace on more towards the front area. Maybe use some, I don't know, Banassi trim or something to go in between here. Okay, I'm still playing around with ideas on what else to use on this, because ideally I would prefer to have got some cream. I may venture to the bazaar and try and get some cream lace to even finish off a slight bit of a length to, you know, I wasn't... The beads are very nice, the beaded lace is very nice, but it's just a little bit small, so I don't know, I'm still playing around with ideas. Up till the point where I actually stitch this, I will be playing around with ideas. Anyway, that's the cutting of the dress complete. Next, we're going to be cutting the lining and the salwar.